There is no other solution, no other exit path except for this path of tawbah. And that is why tawbah is not an option for us. Tawbah is not a voluntary act for us. Tawbah is obligatory and not optional. Tawbah is mandatory upon each and every Muslim, each and every human being. Tawbah is something that we are required to do. It is not an option. When we know we are all sinners, when we know that every one of us is going to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only way out of this is to cleanse ourselves through the cleansing of repentance. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to repent. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. All of you should repent to Allah, جَمِيعًا, each and every one of you, if you wish to be successful. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, O you who believe. This verse is addressed to me and you, each and every Muslim. O you who believe, تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا. Repent to Allah a sincere repentance. Repent to Allah a full and true repentance. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala emphasizes the fact that even repentance is of many types. There is a true repentance. There is a sincere repentance. And Allah commands us to go to that type of repentance. Repent to Allah in the best of all ways. Brothers and sisters, if repentance is obligatory upon all human beings, this means that even the prophets of Allah had to repent. And that is exactly what we find. Do you know that even the prophets of Allah, all of them, they had to seek Allah's forgiveness? Our father Adam alayhi salam, the first human being, our father Adam, he did something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him not to do. He ate of the tree that Allah said, do not eat from it. Iblis, he disobeyed Allah when Allah commanded him. When Allah said to prostrate to Adam, Iblis said no. So both of them disobeyed, Adam and Iblis. But let me ask you, are they the same? Are they at the same level? A'udhu billah, of course not. Why? Why? When both of them disobeyed, why are they not at the same level? Because as for our father Adam, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ قَالَ رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Adam repented. Adam said, oh Allah, I have committed a sin. Oh Allah, if you don't forgive me, if you don't have mercy on me, I will be of those who are destroyed. And as for Iblis, أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. Iblis became arrogant and rejected and was of the kafirin. Adam repented, and so Allah accepted it from him and forgave him, and Adam became a prophet of Allah. Iblis did not repent. Iblis rejected and was arrogant, and so Iblis became the most accursed of Allah's creation. The Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, also asked Allah for something he should not have asked for. He asked Allah to save his son, and Allah had clearly told him, do not ask anyone to be saved who is not a Muslim, and his son was not a Muslim. So when he asked Allah for something he should not have asked, Nuh alayhi salam repented. وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لِي وَتَرْحَمْنِي لَأَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Oh Allah, if you don't forgive me, if you don't have mercy on me, I will be of those who are destroyed. This is the Prophet Nuh alayhi salam repenting to Allah. Ibrahim and Ismail, when they are building the Kaaba, while they are building the holiest structure on earth, they make a dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. Forgive us and accept our repentance. Allow us to be of those who repent and accept it. You are the one who accepts the repentance, and you are the one who forgives. Musa alayhi salam, when he asked to see Allah, and he should not have asked this because he knows, as all the prophets do, that Allah cannot be seen. When he awoke from the coma that he fell into, فَلَمَّا أَفَاقَ قَالَ سُبْحَانَكَ تُبْتُ إِلَيْكَ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Musa alayhi salam says, oh Allah, subhanak, how exalted are you? I am guilty. I turn to you in repentance. Musa was not ashamed to repent to Allah. And how about our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Someone whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven each and every sin. لِيَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكَ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. Allah says in the Quran, each and every sin of yours, we have forgiven it. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith in Sahih Bukhari, indeed, I repent to Allah every single day more than 100 times. 100 times I seek Allah's forgiveness every single day. Let me ask you, brothers and sisters, who do you think is more in need of Allah's mercy? Us sinful people or the holiest of all men, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The answer is obvious. We are more in need of Allah's mercy. So then the question is, if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would seek Allah's forgiveness 100 times a day, how often do you think we need to be seeking Allah's forgiveness? O Muslims, as we said, tawbah is not an option, it is an obligation. Tawbah is fard, it is obligatory upon every single Muslim, every single day of his life. And anybody who reads the Quran and Sunnah cannot help but be overwhelmed by the mercy of Allah, by the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to repent, and then he tells us about how merciful he is. In one verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Who can forgive your sins other than Allah? In another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَقْبَلُ التَّوْبَةَ عَنْ عِبَادِهِ وَيَعْفُ عَنِ السَّيِّئَاتِ. Allah is the one who accepts your repentance and forgives your sins. In yet another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O you who believe, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. O you who believe, O you who have committed sins. Allah is addressing the sinners. O you who have committed sins against your own souls, do not despair of the mercy of Allah. Indeed, Allah can forgive all sins. In fact, we all know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has many names. Of them are 99 that are extra special. And most of these names center around the concept of mercy and forgiveness. Ponder over the names of Allah, Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim, the one who has mercy and the ever-merciful, Al-Ghaffar and Al-Ghafoor, the one who forgives and the one who will be able to remit all of your sins, Al-Afu, the one who erases, At-Tawwab, the one who causes you to repent and then accepts that repentance. So many of Allah's names and attributes center around the concept of mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in the Quran, and the Prophet reminds us in the Sunnah about how magnificent is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in one hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stretches out his hands in the day to accept the repentance of the one who sinned in the night. And Allah stretches out his hand in the night to accept the repentance of the one who sinned during the day. So much so, so great is the mercy of Allah that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam even said, if a non-Muslim only knew how much mercy Allah has, even he would not give up hope of entering Jannah. If a non-Muslim knew and realized how much mercy Allah has, even he would be enthused with optimism that perhaps I can enter Jannah as well. And Shaytan himself, Shaytan challenged Allah. When Shaytan was expelled from Jannah, Shaytan challenged Allah. And Shaytan said, I swear by your honor, Shaytan is swearing by Allah's honor, وَعِزَّتِكَ, I swear by you, O Allah, I will misguide each and every one of them. All of us he's talking about. As long as they have a spirit within their bodies. What was the response of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? I will misguide each and every one of them. This is my duty now. This is what Shaytan said.